Hola Taekwondoistas, this is my first video in my Taekwondo journey. I am reshooting this video because it was shot without audio the first time. And so I'm uploading it late and I'm still getting involved with this whole YouTube thing. So it's all new to me and I'm just getting my message out. So that's the intent. And so this is the first video in my Taekwondo journey where we're going to talk about purpose, why it's important, and your why. And how that leads everything that you do. So how did I get started in Taekwondo? I was actually taking a course by Thomas Wang. He let me in on his time hacking course on how to get things done, how to amp up your productivity, all these time hacking tools that you can use on a daily basis. And one of them was asserting that you have to have a purpose or a goal in your life and everything, every part of your life in order to get where you want to go, right? So it's somewhat like solving a math problem without the equation, trying to get the answer to a math problem without the equation. That's how you're going to be without a goal. And the example he used in his course was fitness. So if you're constantly going to the gym and you don't have a goal, like you want to look a certain way or have certain muscles developed or have proficiency in a sport, you're not going to get anywhere. You're just going to be wasting your time going to the gym every day without a specific purpose or goal, and then your gym life is just not going to be fulfilling. And that kind of hit home on me because I thought, okay, I have a goal and a purpose in everything in my life except for really gym, but I go to the gym to keep up my fitness level. I don't think too much of it. So I said, okay, I'm going to ignore that part of the course that doesn't apply to me. But then all of a sudden, I went to my Muay Thai class, which that's my workout. I work out 6 days a week, and I went to Muay Thai class, and that I realized I didn't like the professor. I didn't like the teacher, but I liked the art. Like, there were parts of the martial art that I truly liked, but having practiced it so long, I didn't really see an improvement. And I didn't have a goal either. And so that kind of hit me and it changed my perspective. And I thought, I love martial arts. Muay Thai might not be right for me. It just doesn't fit who I am as a person completely. I want to delve deep into a martial art. I want to have a goal. I want to learn all the lessons that I can learn by going, you know, progressing in the martial art. And I want something more traditional, like more of a white uniform, because a white uniform symbolizes purity. And I believe that it's great to have that kind of integrity that you bring out to the world. I want that to be part of my whole life. And exercise, fitness, martial arts is going to be, you know, the start of that. That just kind of flows into my whole life. So that was my why. And my purpose for looking up a martial art was I want to gain mastery in a martial art. And I knew that I can only do that by training under a master. I mean, class lessons have, you know, they work up into a point. If you want to progress, you have to have kind of, what is it called? Like immersion. You have to have immersion, like in a short period of time with a master, with someone who has mastered their art. Whoever you learn from is going to take you the farthest. It's the teacher, not the art. And I was looking at several martial arts. I was looking at ninjutsu, karate, taekwondo. And I remembered my old Muay Thai instructor, who I know was very, very good. And I saw his videos on YouTube with Quan Kicker, and you know, from taekwondo, obviously. And Quan Kicker was just so amazing. And I messaged my old Muay Thai instructor and I said, hey, you know, where did you go? I don't see you anymore. And he says, come to this event. I came to it. It was a Muay Thai seminar. I trained for 3 hours that day and I progressed so quickly. It was like an immersion in Muay Thai and I loved it. You know, I progressed so much. I felt great after that, but I knew inside that Muay Thai wasn't really right for me. It didn't fit my goals, my purpose. I had a why, and my why was to become a master, become enlightened as I go up the steps through martial arts, learn as much as possible about myself, project the values of integrity, indomitable spirit, just great virtues in my life, projected as an example out to the world, because I think that's what the world needs most, upstanding, virtuous people with integrity. And that's what drew me to a more traditional martial art that's been around for a long, 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 long time. And I know Muay Thai has its own traditions, but what drew me was the traditional uniform, or the gi in karate, or the gi in Brazilian jiu-jitsu, the dobok in taekwondo, that kind of thing. That kind of discipline that you can instill in every part of your life. I wanted to start. And so what I found out when talking to my Muay Thai instructor, I said, hey, I want to learn more about myself. I want to know more about projecting these great values into society. I want the discipline. I want the physical fitness that's, the epitome of physical fitness. I want, I just want it all, right? I had a great why, and I want to be committed to a new martial art. And he said, hey, I trained in not only Muay Thai, I'm also a second degree black belt in Taekwondo. And I said, what's Taekwondo? That was part on my list, that was on my list. And then I started taking the class, and immediately I felt like I was thrust into Taekwondo, and it wasn't really my first choice, but I went with my spirit, and I went with my intuition, and I loved it. And apparently I take on to it really well. And the more I started doing it, the more I realized it was meant for me. And like recently he said that he's never had someone progress at the rate that I progress. And it's just amazing to see everything flow so naturally to me. Like I've done it before, but I haven't, right? That kind of thing, those kind of signs, those kind of synchronicities is what draws me to the art. And I feel like this was such an inopportune, like a great opportunity that was thrust upon me. And I feel so grateful to be able to share it, to experience it right now, and to share it with everyone what I'm learning. And hopefully someone can teach or take whatever that I teach out into the world, out into real life. Because obviously I'm not teaching Taekwondo steps. I am teaching how I'm using it in my life and how it's improving my life. And hopefully that will give an example to others and how they can improve their life, whether it be following a martial art, following Taekwondo, Muay Thai, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, anything that fits your life and your purpose. Just having that purpose gets you up every morning, puts a smile on your face, for lack of being cliche, I meant to say, puts energy in you, is energy generating. And when you generate that energy within yourself through your passion, through your why, your reason for going to the dojang every morning, or the dojo every morning, if you're doing karate, that's, the essence of life, really. It's being alive, feeling alive, just having your why, having your purpose. And it all started off with Thomas Wang's course, and then the next day going to my Muay Thai class and deciding that I wanted something better. So that's the start of my Taekwondo journey. I'm really happy that all of you guys are listening and joining me on what I'm learning and how I'm applying it to my life, and how, just let the enlightenment flow. So that's it. I hope you guys have a wonderful day, and stay tuned, like and subscribe if you learned something, and I'll see you very soon. And watch as I learn even more cool, YouTube tricks, because right now I'm going to be like a ninja in me.